The Lord be with you.
And
a reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. As Jesus continued his journey to Jerusalem, he traveled through Samaria and Galilee. As he was entering a village, 10 lepers met him. They stood at a distance from him and raised their voices, saying, "Jesus, Master, have pity on us." And when he saw them, he said, "Go show yourselves to the priests." As they were going, they were cleansed. And one of them, realizing he had been healed, returned, glorifying God in a loud voice. And he fell at the feet of Jesus and thanked him. He was a Samaritan. Jesus said in reply, 10 were cleansed, were they not? Where are the other 9? Has none but this foreigner returned to give thanks to God?" Then he said to him, "Stand up and go. Your faith has saved you." The Gospel of the Lord.
It's interesting how we are in our human nature. Luke was a Gentile. Luke might have been a Samaritan or something like that. He was certainly a Greek or something like that. And so he really loves it when the Samaritans or when the Gentiles are the ones that Jesus praises. And he includes those people in his gospel. And today it's not one of the Jewish people, one of the people of Israel, one of God's people who returns and gives thanks. It's one of the opposite. It's one of us. We're all Gentiles too. We're all like Luke, not one of the original people of God. Probably none of us here are Jewish. We're probably all, you know, Gentiles. We're all part of that. And so Luke loves it because the one that returns is a Gentile. The one who says thank you is a Gentile. And so Luke loves Samaria. He'll refer to it later in his other writings in the book of Acts as well. And he'll say the gospel is going to go to Jerusalem, to Judea, to Samaria. That's where they are today. This Gentile was a Samaritan. And then to the uttermost parts of the world. And so in some ways, today, what's being told to us is that the good news, the kingdom of God, is being made available to Gentiles, to us. We're being healed. We're part of it. In the cleansing of the leper, we're being brought into the kingdom of God. But as I prayed about it over the last few weeks, and as I've spoken with my ministry team, and we tried to plan for this Mass, what music were we going to do? It seems like that idea of being thankful is really what stood out to us. One came back and said, "Thank you." I was reading a story just today, and it was just a beautiful story about a small church where a man and a woman were in the church, had lost a son in a war. And so they went to the pastor and they said, "Would it be possible if we gave a gift to the church as a memorial for the life of our son, to just say thank you to God for the life of our son? Would it be possible for us to give a gift to the church?" And the pastor said, "I think that's a wonderful idea." He said, "Would you mind if I said something to the rest of the congregation about it?" And they said, "Yeah, if you want to, you can say something." So he spoke about it to the rest of the church. And on the way home from church, another man and a woman were reflecting on that. And the man said, "Why don't we give a gift to the church on behalf of our son too?" And the wife said, "Well, because he hasn't been in any battles and he's still alive." And the man said, "Even more reason to give thanks to God for a son who's alive than for one who's been lost. And that's kind of the point God's trying to get across to us today. Here we are, all of us, with so much more to be thankful for, and we should all be saying, God, here's my gift for all those things that I should be thankful for. My son is still with me. In fact, I had lunch with my son yesterday. I should be offering a gift to God because I have three wonderful sons, but we wait until the end to offer that. And I have so much to be thankful for. And so in the time of Jesus, if you were a leper, that usually didn't mean you had the kind of leprosy that today is very infectious. It might have just been a psoriasis or any kind of dermatological problems were categorized as leprosy. And you had to leave your family. You had to leave your community. You had to stand off and be marginalized. And I was thinking, we use that phrase for people we marginalize in our lives today, don't we? We use that phrase leprosy and we're like, well, what, do I have leprosy or something? No one will talk to me? And the Pope was doing a homily on this, Pope Francis, and he says, we are called to treat all marginalized people as if they're these lepers. We're called, like Jesus, to touch them. And he said, we actually, like Thomas, put his hand into the wounds of Jesus and was able to touch Jesus. The Pope says, we touch those wounds of Jesus through the people in our world that are marginalized. When we touch them, that's how we are able to touch Jesus. How cool is that idea? We're touching Jesus through them. And so he then lists all those different kinds of people who are marginalized. And there's so many of them. I was talking to a woman just yesterday, and she was in the confessional. I said, can I share this with the congregation? And she said, yeah. I said, I won't mention your name, but her daughter is addicted to heroin. And she couldn't tell anybody, because if your daughter's addicted to heroin, you have leprosy. You are out there. You're not allowed to tell anyone because they'll judge you and they'll talk poorly about you. They'll gossip about you. They'll think all kinds of things. She said, Father, I don't have anyone to tell this to. I just want to tell you. And so we began to talk about that. There's all kinds of leprosy out there, isn't there? And we have to be able to welcome everyone in, and by touching them, by touching those people who are untouchable, we touch Jesus. The Pope says we're able to receive them. We have to look at everyone who's out there and say, there are no people out there. There's only people who are welcome here to come and say, Lord, have mercy on me. And it wasn't any of the self-righteous ones who were already a part of the people of God and thought they deserved it. It was just the one Samaritan. So where did leprosy come from? Well, in the Bible, theologically, it came from Miriam. Miriam is the first one who they talk about having leprosy, and she got it, you know how? By complaining about Moses. And so leprosy, theologically for us, are those times where we complain about our life. We complain about the people in our life, and we complain. The Pope says when you gossip and you complain about people, he says that's murder. That's leprosy. That's what Miriam had. And when Moses, you know who she was complaining about was Moses. And when Moses found out she had leprosy, he's like, no, God, take it away, heal her. And he was considered the most humble man in the Bible. She had just come off of a bout of complaining about him, and he's the one interceding for her. Yeah, he didn't even complain about her complaining about him. I always complain about people who complain about me. And then I should say, thank you for those people who complain about me, because they help me see the real me, don't they? All my friends are always saying, oh, Father, you're so good. And the people who complain about me, talk about me, I'm like, wow, they're the only ones who know me. They're the only ones that know the real me. Isn't that right? I should be thankful because they teach me how to repent. And so Moses prayed for her, and she was cleansed. And so we have now two things to look at. Are we the kind of person in the world who complains? Are we complainers? We have leprosy if we are. We're that person. And Jesus wants to heal all of us and touch all of us and make us then the other kind of person, the ones that are thankful. Just saying thank you all the time to everyone. Not just to the Lord, but just to everyone. Thanks for all you do. Thanks for, and just all that. One person, you know, this right here is called Eucharist. Eucharistia is Thanksgiving. Eucharisteo is the Greek word for I give thanks. And so what we do here is called giving thanks. It's called Thanksgiving. And so what we do as priests, we're all priests by virtue of our baptism. There's a ministerial priesthood, and there's a priesthood by baptism. We all go out and we do Eucharist. We all go out there and give thanks. And so what we're called to do as priests is to bless our world out there, not complain about our world out there. If we complain about our world, we're really, really bad priests. If we bless our world out there, we're really, really good priests. And how do we bless our world out there? By giving thanks. We bless by saying thank you. Thank you, God, for this driver that just cut me off. Thank you, God, for the way that person just treated me. Thank you, God. And we bless them like Moses was able to bless Miriam. We bring blessing into our world. In 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 9, Peter says, in everything, give a blessing. In everything, give thanks. He said, don't repay evil for evil. Don't repay insult for insult. But in everything, be giving a blessing. For this is the reason you were called. This is the reason you were baptized, to be a blessing, to give thanks. And so let me just close with this story. I'm going to cut a little of it out and try to be a little shorter today. I think it was Churchill. Churchill loved to tell stories, and he told some of the best. Most of them I can't repeat to you. You should just look up his quotes. They're wonderful. But he told a story about a little boy who fell off the dock in stormy seas, and he was just a little boy, and this one man who was on the dock without any regard for his own life or the fact that the seas were stormy, jumped off the dock to help save the little boy. And after a struggle with the boy, he was able to get him to shore and to save his life. And the mother of the little boy, 2 days later, came to the dock to find the man who had saved her little boy. And finally, she was able to locate the man. And when she located him, she said, are you the man that saved my little boy? And he stood up a little straighter and said, yes, I am. And she said, well then, where's his hat? Yeah. Ouch. Yeah. Well then, where's his hat? God gives us every good gift, and our response only, always, is to give thanks. We'll hear that as we begin the Eucharist. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Lift up your hearts. We lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Father, Almighty, right? This is our faith. This is our call. This is our reason for being in the world, to give thanks. And what a wonderful call, what a wonderful blessing, what a wonderful faith we have.